Okay, before we can talk metabolic pathways, before we can talk enzymatic catalyst, enzymatic reactions, we have to set some ground rules. These ground rules are known as the laws of thermodynamics. There's two of them. Two of them that you will be held responsible for. I'll tell you right now. They're going to be on the next exam. Okay? So you'll need to know them. Not only know them, be able to explain them with examples. Okay? First law of thermodynamics. Okay? Remember, this thermodynamics is energy being transferred, energy coming from one thing becoming something else. Energy being passed from A to B, whatever. The first law that governs this basically states, and it says right here, I'm going to read it. The first law of thermodynamics states that the total amount of energy in the universe is constant. Energy cannot be created or destroyed. Okay? Energy has to come from somewhere. There's always a source. However much you take in, you have to give somewhere else all of it. Okay? You cannot create energy out of nothing. Energy in your body came from the food you ate. From the plants that you ate in your diet came from the sun. The sun from consuming, you know, hydrogen fission, things like that. You cannot destroy energy. Anytime you try to destroy energy, things like Newton's law, E equals mc squared, comes into play. Energy equals mass times the speed of light squared. Boom. Nuclear bombs. Okay? Boom. Okay? That's taking all of the energy in a set thing. Here, plutonium. Or no. And releasing it all at once. Okay? It's all going to go somewhere. Okay? You can't go in just poof, gone. It's going to be released somewhere. Can't make stuff. Can't get rid of it. Okay? You've got to take the energy from somewhere. The second law of thermodynamics states that the transfer of energy is not completely efficient. Okay? What that means is with each chemical reaction, some energy is lost in a form that is unusable, i.e. heat. The heat that is lost increases entropy, disorder of the universe. So every time you take energy from A and you transfer it to B, there's going to be a little bit of loss in between. How do you think you got the thermal energy to be 37 degrees Celsius, 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit? It's the millions and millions and billions of billions of reactions occurring every second in your body. All those chemical reactions transferring energy from one thing to another in a little bit is lost. Just a finite small amount in every reaction. But it adds up, 37 degrees Celsius, 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. So, the chemical energy becoming the chemical energy of our food. The hamburger you ate for lunch. The cheeseburger you ate for lunch. The pizza you're going to eat for dinner, whatever. Chemical energy in the bonds of all of that stuff that makes up the cheeseburger, the hamburger, the pizza. In your body, those chemical bonds are going to be broken, reformed to make the lipids, to make the proteins, to make the nucleic acid you need for your body. In the breaking down and the remaking, energy is going to be transferred. During that transfer, some of it's going to be lost. Heat. 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, 37 degrees Celsius.